Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 reads as follows. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. For unto us a child is born.
Yes.
Unto us a son is given. This morning I want to talk to you about the only gift I ever needed. The only gift I ever needed was watching the news several mornings ago. It was a tragic story. It was a lady whose house had been shot up. 18 to 20 bullets fired into her house. You might have seen it, the news report said that in the midst of the shooting, her niece was shot in the chest and their dog was killed. The lady who was assumed the owner of the house . She said that she was home because she was terminally ill and she had come home to die, and the words that she said to the camera was this. She said, there will be no Christmas in this house this year. This is not to be critical of her situation, nor to be critical of her predicament. But her statement says something about what we have come to associate with what Christmas is. To many of us, over the course of the years, Christmas has become a feeling. Christmas is associated with what we have called the Christmas spirit. It's a feeling of excitement. A feeling of exuberance, a feeling of cheerfulness. And I believe that it is tied very closely to gift giving. I remember growing up as a small child. And right after Halloween came, JCPenney would come out with the holiday catalog. And I would take the holiday catalog back to my room. And y'all, I would spend hours going through, picking out what I wanted. This. I want that. And all that anticipation, things that I wanted, culminated on December 25th with an eager I would get up in the morning to go down and see what I got. Because there was a lot of things that I wanted. And I was excited when I got the things that I wanted. I was excited when I would pick up the package and it was heavy. And it would clack. I was not excited when I picked up a package and it was light. And if you shook it, it would go shoo, 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 shoo. Because that meant it was probably a sweater or some pants. It was all about what I wanted. Y'all understand this, and this is important. There is a difference between a want and a need. A want is always tied to some desire that we have. It's a desire to have something. It's tied, oftentimes tied to just something we want. Look, when I wanted a 10-speed bike. You know why I wanted a 10-speed bike? Because Mark Malone, who lived down the street, he had a 10-speed bike. Wants are tied to our desires. But then, church, there are our needs. There are two kinds of needs. The first one, y'all, is a false need. All right. A false need is simply a disguised want. I need a drink. I need a smoke. Some men say they have some needs that just require a cold shower. Amen. Amen. If they're just disguised wants. But then there are true needs. True needs are necessary for your survival. A true need is required for your very existence. A true need is something that you must have if you're going to keep on going. Jesus is a true need. Amen. It's okay to say amen.
Amen.
Jesus is a true need. He's a true need because of the sin problem.
Amen.
The sin problem. Because you and I have a sinful nature, church. Because we have a sinful nature, you and I were born with a death sentence. To be born with a death sentence means that you have a set appointment with death. Your appointments are made to be kept. You have a set appointment with death. You have a day, an hour, and a minute that is designed to be your last. Because that's what happens when you have a death sentence. Let me illustrate this way. Stanley Williams, his nickname was Tookie. Stanley Williams was born to a 17-year-old mother. and a father who deserted him and his family before he was even 1 year old. At age 18, he joined and helped to build a street gang called the Crips. At age 26, he was charged with 4 vicious murders. At age 27, he was tried, found guilty, and sentenced to death. At age 35, he appealed to the United States District Court, and his appeal was unsuccessful. At age 43, 17 years into his incarceration, he saw the errors of his way, and he began to publish some books. He did the first of a series of books that he did that were designed to be anti-gang, that encouraged young people not to join gangs. At age 44, he wrote a public apology. He apologized for his role in starting that street gang, the Crips. He said in his apology that he was a changed man. At age 48, he wrote another book warning young people not to follow after his lifestyle. Don't enter into a life of crime. And for his efforts as the series of books and the power and the compassion in which he wrote, he was actually nominated. While he was in prison, he was nominated 6 times for a Nobel Peace Prize. At age 49, he appealed to the United States Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals. But his appeal was once again unsuccessful. The court actually praised him for his anti-gang efforts. At age 52, after being incarcerated for 26 years, his appeal became before the United States Supreme Court. Once again, it was unsuccessful. As a last hope, Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger, he would appeal to Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger, someone who he had met and knew before all of the stuff happened in his life, someone who he knew. He would appeal to him because maybe that the governor would commute his sentence from a death sentence to life imprisonment. But even from his friend, he was unsuccessful. And just before his 53rd birthday, Stanley Tookie Williams, his death sentence was carried out. And he was executed by lethal injection. Church, he had a death sentence. Because he had a death sentence, he had a set appointment with death. And appointments are to be kept. Nothing changed his appointment. Not to tragedy of his childhood, not his change of heart, not the recognition of his community service, not his pleas into the criminal justice system, not the people that he knew. No, no. He had an appointment to make. Death by lethal injection. Somebody might be saying, well, why does that? Why does any of this matter to me? Because you and I were also born with a death sentence. You and I have a set appointment with death. And appointments are made to be kept. Tookie had to die death by lethal injection. But you and I are sentenced to death by eternal separation from God. If you die eternally separated from God, then I tell you, you are without hope and without God, even right now.
Yes.
Eternal separation. Let me explain it this way. If a branch from a tree were to break off from the tree, the branch supplies and adds nothing to the tree, and the tree cannot supply anything to the branch. Therefore, that branch is then gathered up with other branches that have been fallen, and they are to be burned. Eternal separation from God takes those who have been eternally separated, gathers them all together in a place where there will be wailing and gnashing of the teeth. You and I have an appointment, a set appointment with death. But you know what? There is one thing that could have saved Stanley Williams. It could have saved him from his execution. Y'all, if there was somebody who would have claimed that they were him, and if that somebody would then have volunteered to take the blame for him, and then if that somebody was willing to go ahead and suffer the punishment for him, then Stanley Williams could live. Well, church, out of the billions of people that were living on earth at the time, there was not one person who would stand up and claim to be him.
All right, all right.
There was not one person who came forward and said, I'm God. tragedies that happened in your childhood, not the good works that you have done, not the people that you know, not the money that you have in your bank account. There's nothing, nothing, there is nothing that is going to change your appointment with death. However, there is one thing. There is one thing. Yo, we just needed one person. We just needed one person out of the trillions of people in world history. We just needed one person who would claim to be us. We just needed one person who was willing to take the blame for us. We just needed one person who would suffer a punishment called death in our place. Just one person. And because God so loved the world, his body, laid it down in the bottle tomb. He stayed.